Junaid, I don't understand what I don't know. I'm sorry, Junaid, but I don't understand this line of
this.
I don't understand this line.
What do you want the government to do?
Well, one minute. Not me. Let me tell you this. Not me. Now put this question to everyone and anyone tonight. Mehboob Beg will agree, Seshadri Chari will agree, and Brahma Chalani will agree. The entire country, Seshadri Chari right now, wants a stronger statement from the Indian government, from their own government, on what has happened in Kiran, directly condemning the role of the Pakistani establishment, acknowledging what the Indian Army Chief has said, and thereby warning the Pakistani government to
government might
one
do
minute
that.
What to restrain.
No, government might do that.
When?
We don't know.
When?
We cannot determine
when?
Government's
especially,
time.
When?
Why should we presume government is not doing anything?
Why are you speaking government for the government? They haven't spoken yet.
I'm not speaking for the government.
They haven't spoken
for anybody who is advocating peace and patience. I'm just advocating peace and patience.
I am not
interested in any.
Kumar Ketkar, 1 minute. No government needs to be. No government ought to need to be goaded by the media or the people
not
of this country on
no,
the ordinance.
Take its own time.
Let me not remind you on the ordinance, the way the government had to be goaded by its own political party. And on this particular case, I don't know what the government is waiting to be goaded by. But, if the government keeps quiet, how will it look, Seshadri Chari?
I don't know. The government did the same thing when it was the incursion from Chinese side in Ladakh. It was for the media to expose that the Chinese PLA had intruded almost 14 kilometers inside the border. Afterwards, the Prime Minister sent out an emissary from his office, Mr. Shyam Sharan, who gave a report, and your channel discussed that report at length, where the ITBP told them that it is not just 14 kilometers but more than 600 kilometers, that is what the PLA has intruded. Even on this account, the Prime Minister kept quiet. The Army Chief also kept quiet. Nobody spoke anything about it. It was the media which exposed this. Again, even in Pakistan side, this border thing which has taken place, it is the media which has exposed. And this is exactly where we want the Prime Minister to come clean on this issue. Mr. Kumar Ketkar wants to know why the Prime Minister should come clean on every day.
Yeah.
If he is not coming clean on every issue, this is what will happen. For the sake of security of this country, the Prime Minister has to come clean. Otherwise, every High Commissioner will do this. Pakistan has had a very clear policy. In 1947-48, they had Operation Venus. In 1965, they had Operation Gibraltar. In 1999, they had Operation Kargil. And every time they said, even in 1962, there are records which says Pakistan really was sorry because they did not take advantage of the Chinese aggression.
Precisely.
And let me remind you, your own channel showed a small news item yesterday, which you have also missed and everybody seems to be missing. Just as this thing was going on in Karen, there was a news report put out by Times Now yesterday that China is building up its military operational strength in the western sector near Bhutan. This was a news item put out by you. So let us connect Pakistani action on border and the Chinese action.
I agree.
There is a definite strategy behind all these things.
You see,
and
there
this
are
is all the more serious if the Prime Minister chooses to keep quiet on these issues.
You see, one point. You see, this is a question that unfortunately all the doves have missed out. What are the self-proclaimed doves missing out? The self-proclaimed doves, and I'm not in Kumar Ketkar, don't look at me like that, because you know you feel you are taking everything personally today. I'm just saying this on a broader note to all the doves watching tonight. These doves are not realizing the dangers of the Prime Minister keeping quiet. Today in Maruf, the Northern Army commander, the senior most officer there who spoke after the Army Chief, Lieutenant General Sanjeev Chachra, he clearly said that this is going to continue. This is going to be the trend till the onset of winter. Now, I think the danger is, Maruf, that if the Prime Minister keeps quiet, if the Defence Minister keeps quiet, there's no political pressure, if the Foreign Minister keeps quiet and only lets the Army do the batting, that means you're saying that the Army deal with the problem. You got no political support from us. We will carry on with these interminable talks, and the Army will deal with the situation once in a while.
A very important question.
Exactly. That's the only question tonight. Yes, Maruf.
Arnab, that's a very important question you have raised. Arnab, that's a very important point you have raised. Ever since the beheading of our soldiers took place, our political establishment has lost control of the management of the relationship with Pakistan on the LOC and the borders. They must get back into the play. They must revisit their entire strategy. They must rethink on how to deal with Pakistan. There are ways to deal with Pakistan. The second point is, and some of the people defending the government and the Prime Minister have said, do you want every little incident the Prime Minister to react to? Is the loss of so many soldiers, is the loss of lives of so many of our brave men a little incident? And the same Prime Minister has said it cannot be business as usual. The same Prime Minister has reacted to a small remark by Rahul Gandhi and returned the whole ordinance. And that was not, good enough for you to turn to take a stand. After all, the whole cabinet had apparently previously, in their entire wisdom, had thought through what to do. And suddenly Rahul Gandhi had to remind them they had all got it wrong. And here the whole nation is asking for a response. And you say it's a little incident. Let me also tell you, sir, that Pakistan understands historically, please read India-Pakistan relations. They understand a response of strength. They understand your ability to talk, from your ability to inflict pain. If you can't do that, no amount
precisely
of talk about being Maru a nuclear Shah, power Maru will Maru do Shah, you any you good because you have lost Maru the ability Maru, to deter the enemy to trouble you.
Are you advocating war with
goes
Pakistan?
Emotional. He's emotional on everything.
I am not, sir. I have just articulated to you how many ways you can inflict pain on Pakistan. Junaid, don't interrupt, please.
It is not the question of emotion. I am very sorry to say, Mr. Junaid,
1 minute, please come in when I allow you to. Yes.
Pure and simple strategy. Please remember that this is not emotion.
Sorry,
we are not dealing with a child. We are not dealing with a juvenile criminal. We are dealing with a country which has inflicted some of the most major heinous crimes on us, for instance, since 1947-48. They have fought five wars.
I am objecting.
Their strategy is to cut this wound from you and bleed you. We are not dealing with a small. One minute. I have one thing to say to Mahbub Beg.
Tonight, one second. To Mahbub Beg.
If the Indian army loses people, is there no emotion in that?
To Mahbub Beg.
I do not have emotions for that.
To Mahbub Beg.
It's not in
to Mahbub Beg, Junaid Matu, please come in when I allow you to. 1 minute.
Do not, 1 minute,
Junaid. Don't interrupt me right now. To Mahbub Beg, who attacks Maruf Raza and says Maruf Raza is always emotional. Let me tell you, Mahbub Beg, it is better for Maruf to be emotional and feel about what his country is going through, like all of us, than to be a politician and be a hypocrite. Because you know what Farooq Abdullah said in August after the death of five soldiers? Let me, 1 minute, 1 minute. 1 minute, Mahbub Beg, let me follow up. Let me follow up with what he said.
No.
1 minute, Mahbub Beg. If you don't have the courage to listen to what I will say now.
Judgments on everything.
You no 1 minute.
You can have a view.
Passing judgments, Mahbub Beg, Mr. Beg, calm down. Let me tell you the facts. Because you are afraid. You are afraid today of what I'm going to say next. You are scared of what I'm going to say next.
Nobody is afraid. You are afraid,
otherwise you wouldn't interrupt me.
You have drawn conclusions.
Don't interrupt me and I will say something.
Please don't draw conclusions.
You have drawn a conclusion which is wholly and completely wrong. And let me tell you why I think it is wrong to be hypocritical.
You have drawn a conclusion.
And, I'll tell you. No, one second.
I have a view.
Mahbub Beg, hold your view. But then allow me to expose that view today. Please allow me. I take 30 seconds and then you respond. Let's understand that.
Expose your view, please.
Well, let me explain it with facts.
Let all viewers know all the views.
Mr. Mahbub Beg, let me tell you this. You can never accuse us of inconsistency. You can never accuse us of inconsistency. I can accuse you and your party of inconsistency. Because Farooq Abdullah in August said after the death of five soldiers, and have the courage to listen to it, he said the people of India, he said, 1 minute. 1 minute.
Problem.
1 minute. Farooq Abdullah said this. You don't want to listen. You are scared. You're scared to listen.
You don't behave as an anchor.
Mr. 1 minute. Don't tell me how I should behave as an anchor. Mahbub Beg, I'm asking you one question today. Listen to what Farooq Abdullah said. Farooq Abdullah said this. Please do not interrupt me, please. Listen to what Farooq Abdullah said. Farooq Abdullah, your party's leader Farooq Abdullah said after the death of five soldiers, and he said this: the people of India will not want that our soldiers keep on dying and we keep talking about friendship. Both cannot go on at the same time. That was not Maruf Raza speaking. That was Farooq Abdullah speaking.
Prime Minister also said the same.
Really?
But then you can't...
Really? No, so you are taking a different line now.
To move forward.
And when somebody says what he's saying, you are saying that the other person is getting emotional.
No, taking a there different you are. Line. Please, Arnab, nobody is taking a different line. But you can't get stuck there. You have to move forward.
Stuck? I quoted what your leader said. Did you say can't get stuck? What should we get stuck on?
Move forward how, sir?
You have to
move forward.
How?
Articulate your vision.
Move forward.
Come on.
Move towards peace and progress.
How?
First you take them on and then let's move forward.
By resolving issues, by talking.
Sir, peace will come from both sides. Both sides have to respect peace.
Absolutely right. Who says only from one side? It has to come from both sides. As it came during Atal Bihari Vajpayee's time, because he had the political will to go
ahead. Are they doing that?
Closing comments on the debate. 4 minutes left on the News Hour debate tonight. 4 minutes left on the News Hour debate. Let us say this. Let us say this.
Are they doing that now? Is this evidence of peace?
Everybody has to hold their views.
Let me say this.
Everybody has to hold their views. But
let me say this.
You get to expound your views, but everybody has to hold
Junaid, 1 minute. Please come in when I let you to.
What is the alternative?
1 second. 1 minute, Junaid. 1 minute, please.
Let me to.
Junaid, watch. So, Shadri Chari, 96 ceasefire violations by Pakistan this year, highest in the last 8 years. Latest flare-up. Before the latest flare-up, there were 18 ceasefire violations in 1 month alone. These are recorded facts. Okay, almost as many number of violations as in 2009, which were 29. There are 18 in 1 month alone, which means nowadays you have probably 6 or 7 times the density of infiltrations which are happening. I don't think this country can afford to be blind about this anymore. And if you are asking the questions, I don't think anyone can respond by saying, oh, you're being so emotional. No self-respecting country will let such a situation go unattended. All I'm saying today is, let the Prime Minister of India speak. We want to hear the Prime Minister speak. That's all.
We saw 3 full-fledged wars.
That's all. We are saying speak up.
We didn't resolve
speak
the
up
issues.
Without encouragement or goading. Seshadri Chari.
Arnab, we had 3 full
Seshadri Chari.
We are not saying that, no, sir. We are
Seshadri
not
Chari,
that
2 minutes on the debate. We have debate number 2 coming up in 5 minutes. Seshadri Chari.
Arnab, why we are saying that this Prime Minister should come clean? Actually, we are trying to give an exit route to this Prime Minister. See, right from the times of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, when she wanted to take action in 1971 during the Bangladesh war, she consulted opposition parties, and one of the envoys that she sent was Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee to UN and other places to talk about all these issues. Narasimha Rao did it. Even Atal Bihari Vajpayee did it. During Atal Bihari Vajpayee's time, services of former prime ministers were drawn. And this is an ongoing process. Every prime minister is expected to take the advantage of the earlier prime minister's experience in dealing with Pakistan and other issues also. So all that we expect this prime minister is to keep the links with our own people.
Just speak up and take
open.
Them on. That's all.
The media is not against this prime minister.
Let the Indian
the
army
is not against this prime minister. Mind you, again, on your show today, I am telling you, officially, we are not against talks. We have never said we should not talk.
But talks are not the issue, silence
is. Talk, but have a strategy. Talk, but have an agenda. Talk from a position of strength.
Okay, gentlemen.
Not talking from
closing comments from Brahma Chalani. Closing comments from Brahma Chalani.
Do
you expect
have a strategy?
Do you expect the government to speak up finally? Brahma Chalani, expect the government to speak up finally, and should they? You
want clarification? I did not say little incident. I said every incident. Let Prime Minister not come clean every day on every
this
incident.
This is not a every incident.
I did
incident.
Not say little incident.
This is
I did not say it's a common
this
sense
is not
incident.
An every incident.
I did
incident.
Not say it's a little incident.
Our forces have been fighting them for 15
serious.
Days.
It I is very serious. And irrelevant.
It is very serious. And
I
to
said
expect,
very serious, but yeah, I really said that does not mean necessarily the Prime Minister should come every time, every day.
External Affairs Minister, Foreign Minister, Political Establishment, Defence Minister, somebody. Too much to expect?
But I am not expecting
Kumar Ketkar sahab, this is not a small incident.
But I'm not saying it is small.
This is
Seshadri,
not a
I did not say little incident. I did not say small incident. I did not say irrelevant incident. I merely said Prime Minister may have his own reasons for keeping quiet. And therefore, we should not expect him to react to every single day to the media's questions. I am not disrespecting media. I am not disrespecting Prime Minister. Why should we presume? Why should we presume that Prime Minister also has? But why should we not? Why should we not recognize that Prime Minister is also a patriot? Prime Minister is not.
No, one second. Who's questioning the Prime Minister?
Prime Minister doesn't want
one minute. We are recognizing the fact that he is a patriot.
Whatever Prime Minister may be doing, you can say what Prime Minister is doing is wrong.
You are not doubting his patriotism.
Gentlemen, one second.
You are right in saying Prime Minister is doing wrong, but he has his own reasons. He has his own reasons, perhaps.
But keeping quiet on this incident is not patriotism.
But he has his own reasons.
No, one minute. You know, the problem is very easy, but not on this channel. Very easy to distract. First of all, we're not talking about talks. We're not questioning patriotism. We are only and only questioning official silence. And silence today is not good. That's only one point we are making. Brahma Chalani, going forward from now, will we, in your view, see some more aggressive statements coming in from New Delhi, from the political establishment?
What your debate has highlighted is the need for India to change course. If we do not change course, if we stay on the present track, it will be an open invitation to Pakistan to bring India's border security under siege. Because we have seen a pattern of increasing Pakistani cross-border aggression.
Yeah.
And this pattern will escalate without India changing course. And that course needs to be changed if he articulates a clear vision on our Pakistan policy. But if he continues to pursue a meandering course on Pakistan,
it won't help.
A personality-driven foreign policy towards Pakistan, afraid we will see...
It certainly won't help. Well, on that note, the onus is now on the political leadership. I thank all our panelists for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.